Thank you. You may be seated, faculty. Welcome, everyone. My name is Dr. John Granito, and I'm the Dean for the California Health Sciences University College of Osteopathic Medicine. It's my distinct pleasure to welcome you to this class of 2025 White Coat Ceremony. I will ask you to take a moment to silence your phones so they're not a distraction, and also keep your face masks on when you're in the audience and when you're inside the building. You are welcome to take photos from your seats. Please remain in your seats and not in the aisles, as we will have professional photography and video being recorded today. At this time, I'd like everyone to rise as we introduce our a cappella group as they sing the national anthem. At this time, we'll wait for the procession of the class of 2025 as they enter the stadium. Audience, please be seated as the class of 2025 enters the auditorium. Thank you for your patience. Thank you. Once again, good morning, and at this time, I call to the stage our student doctor, members of our a cappella group, to sing the national anthem. Will you all please rise? Thank you again to the student doctors of the class of 2025 and 24 who make up the a cappella group. What a wonderful rendition of the national anthem. It is my honor to welcome all of you, and I'd like to first welcome the trustees of the Board of Trustees and our president, Flo Dunn, seated over here. Welcome to them. I also welcome our esteemed faculty, many of whom who are seated on the stage, who teach our students every day. As you could imagine, putting on an event this complex and sophisticated and keeping the speaker to his script is no small task, led by the many staff who are working right now as they checked you in behind the scenes and making sure everybody is in their place. So thanks to the staff who have helped put this together. And of course, a very special welcome to the guests and family members of the class of 2025, without whom your support, they would not be here today. Student doctors of the class of 2025, thank you for the diligence and seriousness with which you have taken your studies so far. The faculty interviewed you, recommended you for admission, and we chose you all to be here for a reason, and I'm confident you will continue to rise to meet that challenge. I'm also very proud that our CHSU community of students better represent the populations we serve through our university and our medical community's focused efforts on diversity, equity, and inclusion, both in medicine and in medical education. Sir William Osler said, "Medicine is a science of uncertainty and an art of probability." And that science and art mixture and that balance comes through. Let me tell you a little history of white coats. Lab coats such as mine and the ones the faculty are wearing were first worn by scientists over 100 years ago. Scientists wore them mostly to protect their skin and clothing when they were working in laboratories. At that same time, physicians who were practicing wore very formal costume, a professional attire that included frock coat, black pants with a white shirt under a black vest, maybe a top hat, maybe a gold watch or a cane to show their sophistication. Physicians made mostly house calls to their patients' homes, and this costume helped inspire respect and trust, and sometimes obedience, to the orders that they were giving their patients and their families, as well as the household staff. You may not realize that over 100 years ago, originally, medicine was practiced mostly on tradition rather than on scientific evidence. And it was scientific discoveries like the germ theory that is the basis for how vaccines have been developed over the past 100 years. Those discoveries led to medical education being overhauled in 1910, a very important date. Rigorous curriculum were added, including research in laboratories and more formal clinical experiences. Back in the day, diploma mills closed, and medical degrees that had been obtainable simply through apprenticeships were no longer sanctioned. That transition towards a more academic rigor in the curriculum marked an academic overhaul, and so to distinguish themselves from those older physicians, these new physicians with academic credentials decided to add the scientist's white coat to their costume. And doctors started wearing these long white lab coats at that time, signaling then that medicine was now practiced on scientific principles rather than just tradition. And this became the official costume worn by doctors. Medical students, of course, are learners along the continuum and wear the traditional short white coat. The first official white coat ceremony was in 1993 at the Columbia University School of Medicine in New York. Although the University of Chicago claims they were first in 1989. Grants given financially through the Arnold P. Gold Foundation supports this event at every medical school around the country, financially, in the US, and as such, the students have received a pin from the Arnold P. Gold Foundation, and it's one of the first pieces of bling you can put on your white coat. But the white coat ceremony also, according to Arnold P. Gold, should symbolize one of the many steps and rites of passage in teaching professionalism and medical ethics, a vital part of all medical school curriculum, the first step towards professional identity formation. So this ceremony signifies the beginning of your medical journey, ultimately ending when you receive your long white coat during residency training. It is now with great pleasure that I invite our keynote speaker, Rebecca Rodriguez Regner, D.O., to deliver her address. You can read her wonderful bio in the program, and we are proud to have Dr. Rodriguez Regner here today because of her many accomplishments and her passion to improve healthcare by helping shape policy at the national level. Dr. Rodriguez Regner.
Thank you to Dean John Granado for having me to speak at the California Health Sciences University College of Osteopathic Medicine. It is truly an honor and a privilege to be part of your memorable white coat ceremony. As I stand here before you, I can recall the excitement, the honor, and the relief that you made it. Take a breath, live in this moment to experience the joy and recall the hard work and sacrifice it took for you to get to this place in your education and training. Everyone is so proud of you. At the end of the 19th century, Dr. Granado mentioned that the white coat became known as the cloak of compassion and a symbol of caring and hope patients to expect to receive from their physicians. The white coat symbolizes the other critical part of your medical education, a standard of professionalism, caring, and an emblem of the trust you must earn from your patients. Today, as you have your white coat placed upon you, you accept to be held to the highest of standards by your classmates, teachers, and your community. It is important to reflect on, why did you go into medicine? Everyone has their specific reasons, but we all take on the torch to serve people. We commit ourselves to recognize and treat each patient encounter with the three osteopathic tenets we learn: mind, body, and spirit. We are here to take care of people, our family, and our community. You are here at CHSU-COM to be part of something greater, to create a community of cultural health and wellness and grow the Central Valley. The educational design of your school is innovative, technologically amazing, and strong with your local staff support. This school is unique to incorporate Central Valley region culture, nutrition, and rotation sites in your own hometown to have the community here around you and serve them for years to come. CHSU-COM is exceptional to help develop you as future physicians, to provide care to an underrepresented community, and learn the second most important language. The systems-based approach curriculum, teamwork approach development, and opportunity for research and community projects is so very special. As your school gives you 100% plus with education and training, always remember to give back. My lifelong mentor, Dr. Craig Phelps, is a great example, as he has always been the most giving of his time, teaching to students, his medical school, and his community. He has instilled in me that no matter what specialty you choose, you are there to help people. People will come to you because they are ill, injured, scared, or wanting reassurance that they are healthy. Dr. Phelps, along with my dad, encouraged me to believe that no dream is too big. If you want to be a physician at the Olympics, go for the gold. If you want to cure a disease, make it happen. If you want to do a million stellar surgeries, go get it. If you want to start a foundation, impact the world. All is possible with hard work, determination, and a strong support system. I would like to leave you with these important words from a very special book that inspires me and I read to my son frequently. It's called You're Here for a Reason by Nancy Tillman. You're here for a reason, It's totally true. You're part of a world that is counting on you. Life works together, the good and the bad, the silly, the awful, and happy and sad. To paint a big picture we can't always see, a picture, this region, that needs you most definitely. Remember the next time a day goes all wrong, to somebody else, you'll always be strong. You're here for a reason. If you think you're not, I would just say that perhaps you forgot. A piece of the world that is precious and dear would surely be missing if you weren't here. If not for your smile and your laugh and your heart, this place we call home would be minus a part. You are now a lifelong learner. You will not know all the answers, but that is what your colleagues and your friends that you sit next to and people that you meet along the way are for. Medicine is a teamwork effort, and your medical school is always here to support you. I ask that you remind yourself every so often in your career five things. Why did you go into medicine? To give back to community and your medical school. To pay it forward and help future students to be successful. To take time to keep your own self healthy so that you can be at your best and take care of others. And recognize your accomplishments and celebrate the difference that you make every day to all the people around you. Congratulations, best of luck to you and your endeavors. If you can imagine it, you can become it. If you can dream it, you can achieve it. Thank you.
Thank you for your inspiring words, Dr. Rodriguez-Regner. That was very helpful, that I hope many of our students listen, follow in your example to advocate for change, both nationally and locally, to achieve our mission to improve healthcare outcomes and advance healthcare access and equality for our diverse population. Now I will ask students in the first row to please stand and get ready to queue up to your left as we begin the presentation of our white coats. Tradition has it that a more senior member of the physician faculty is the person or persons to place the coats. And so I ask Dr. Lisa Chun, Associate Dean, and Dr. Joanna Jackson, Department Chair, to take their place on the center stage. And I invite Dr. Ann Van Garcie, Associate Dean, to the podium to announce the student doctors' names. I would also like to recognize and thank the Osteopathic Physicians and Surgeons of California, the OPSC, for their generous donation of these white coats. In fact, they donate to all three DO schools in California, and the students' white coats have a patch on them, on their sleeve, reflecting their student membership in the OPSC.
Tia Abu Sham. Shaquille Ahmed. Najiha Alam. Fahad Aleem. Daniel Amaya. Catherine Ju Young An. Shreya Atitkar. Sandy Ong. Khalid Azizi. Jasleen Baines. Daniel Bondock. Kyle Beeler. Yannette Benyam. Everett Blau. Jamandeep Brow. Abigail Buckland. Cassandra Carrillo. Jennifer Cecilini. Kevin Chan. Stephen Chow. Joshua Cho. Kieran Chohan. Suji Choi. Cross White. Win Dang. Brandon Edwin DeGuzman. Austin Dean. Christian Dean. Corey DeLisi. Roy Demeter. Sumit Dillon. Genevieve Doctolero. Yeah. Evan Doucette. Milena Dragovich. Kunal Dudeja. Christopher Ewens. Alan Falks. Katayun Fetat. Cade Fountain. Chitra Chandani Gazula. Joshua Gilbert. Dominic Giuliani.
Thank you so much.
Samarth Gopal. Rajvarun Graywall. Vishal Kumar Gupta. Aditya Gurbani. Maya Hall. Amanda Helly. Hachik Hamayakyan. David Holm. Megan Holm. George Abdallah Harani. Brian Huerta. Aaron Huntington. Kushmanjeet Jawanda. Michael Jones. Sabrina Jones. David Joseph. Parmveer Kalodi. Avery Kaplan. Vishali Kapoor. Joshua Karen. Navdeep Kaur. Sarai Killick. Alan Kim. Sonali Koduri. Ellie Lasitovich. Arash Latifi. Cindy Lee. Joyce Lynn. Tom Liu. Kevin McKay. Samira Malipati. Elora Malik. Fahad Mola. Manpreet Narwal. Meredith Nastris. Abhijit Nayak. James Nelson. Darren No. Chow Win. Brendan O'Brien. Victoria Pirelli. Anish Patel. Delana Payton. Kimberly Fong. Sunny Park. Omar Popal. Chelsea Preciado. Courtney Pritchard. Sondia Perigala. Hamza Rana. Cedar Robertson. Saavedra. Siam Salman. Manveer Sandhu. Dion Santander. Shannon Savino. Rhea Shashodia. Sukmani Kaur Sidhu. Tajinder Singh. Pulkit Singhal. Christina Sue. Dexter Tan. Olivia Tandajaya. Kathy Tran. Alexa Tweet. Joshua Valenzuela. Joel Varughese. Christian Velasco. Sarah Wally. Matthew Wen. Alvin Wong. Jessica Wu. Marvin Wu. Congratulations, and a giant round of applause to all of our student doctors, class of 2025. At this time, I would like to introduce to the podium Dr. Lisa Chun, Associate Dean, who will lead the osteopathic oath.
Hi, everyone. Please rise. You'll find the oath in the back pages of your program. Students, osteopathic physicians, and those physicians who feel comfortable reading the oath, please recite after me. I do hereby affirm my loyalty to the profession I am about to enter. I will be mindful always of my great responsibility to preserve the health and life of my patients. To retain their confidence and respect, both as a physician and a friend, who will guard their secrets with scrupulous honor and fidelity. To perform faithfully my professional duties. To employ only those recognized methods of treatment consistent with good judgment and with my skill and ability. Keeping in mind always nature's laws and the body's inherent capacity for recovery. I will be ever vigilant in aiding in the general welfare of the community. Sustaining its laws and institutions. Not engaging in those practices which will in any way bring shame or discredit upon myself or my profession. I will give no drugs for deadly purposes to any person, though it be asked of me. I will endeavor to work in accord with my colleagues in a spirit of progressive cooperation. And never by word or by act cast imputations upon them or their rightful practices. I will look with respect and esteem upon all those who have taught me my art. To my college, I will be loyal and strive always for its best interests and for the interests of the students who will come after me. I will be ever alert to further the application of basic biologic truths to the healing arts. And to develop the principles of osteopathy, which were first enunciated by Andrew Taylor Still. Thank you very much. Please be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Chun, for leading us in the oath. And thank you, Drs. Chun and Dr. Jackson, for putting on the white coats of the class of 2025. And of course, thank you to Dr. Ann Van Garcie for reading and pronouncing all 199 names, both classes today. So, student doctors, when someone in the clinical setting now sees you in your short white coat, it's their signal that you are a learner. It's a symbolic costume, and we wear it as we perform the art and the show, the stage of medicine. In medical school, the curriculum we give you gives you the scientific and clinical tools to become doctors. But just as importantly, this white coat symbolizes other critical parts of your medical education, the standard of professionalism, the caring, the humanism. It is an emblem of the trust you must earn from and display to the patients and their families. To the family and friends gathered here, this is really an unprecedented time for all of us with the pandemic, but really an unprecedented time for your loved ones seated in the first four rows here. They have been and will continue to be busier than ever. Don't be surprised if they need to miss an important family gathering because of the serious work that their studies require. They must spend most of their time studying and most of their days studying. That is the reality of medical school. As a commitment to the profession, they work hard to gain that knowledge base, and yet we still need to find time to balance their humanism. Humanism is making sure that the patient in front of you knows that they are the most important thing on the physician's mind during that encounter. Those are powerful connections you make with other human beings. Patients respect that connection that comes with seeing a doctor and knowing the trust and respect they place in you. And that is unlike any other profession. You will develop and continue to develop your professionalism through relationships, reflection, resilience. Those are some of the things that you wear all the time, even when you don't have your white coat on. But when you put the white coat on, each time you put it on, each time we put it on, it reminds us of the honor that those patients trust us with their secrets. The honor to provide care for another human being. Remember also, your words are very powerful. At the end of the day, your patients want your opinion, your synthesis of education that you are encountering now and will continue. But maybe more importantly, those patients want your understanding of their condition. They want you to listen to them. You all grew up at some point with the goal of going to medical school. Now you have a goal of graduating from medical school and getting a residency, etc. At some point, the goal will shift away to something bigger. You all said, and you truly believed it, you were doing this to help people. But it's not about you anymore. It's about what you're getting to be in the best you can be to get the patient's honor and trust in you. You are now officially part of the, if not the, one of the most noble, time-honored, and impactful professions, and you will change healthcare and the healthcare landscape in the Central Valley for generations to come. At this point, student doctors, I'd like you to stand. And at this point, I'll call on the faculty to stand as well. To the faculty, I present to you the class of 2025. Now, class, if you'll do an about face and look at the audience. I will now ask the class to give thanks to those in the audience that have helped get them here today. And so the class, please appreciate those seated here with a round of applause. And to all here, once again, I present to you the California Health Sciences University College of Osteopathic Medicine Class of 2025. One tiny additional piece. You may not know, in each of the white coats, in each of their pockets, the class of 2025 found a note written to them by a member of the class of 2024. If you could all hold up your notes. And let's give an applause, even though they're not here, to the class of 2024 for writing these beautiful notes. Invited guests, everyone please be seated as the students will recess out. Invited guests, please remain in your seats until the student doctors have recessed. Our marshals today, Dr. Paula Gregory, Dr. Sam Katavokolu, will escort the students out roughly the same route they came in. And as we recess, we'll all remain in our seats until all of the student doctors have left the building. So at this time, will the first row of students stand and turn to your right and follow the faculty marshals as we recess out. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Board of Trustees and administration and faculty, I'd like to thank you all for joining us. This concludes the ceremony. You're free to exit up the stairs at any of the exits you see. Thank you all.